Okay, good morning, everyone. My name is Muchlisin from Syekh Kuala University in Aceh, Indonesia. Firstly, I'd like to thank Martin for inviting me to come to this center, and other colleagues already come in this seminar, especially my colleague from Indonesia, Professor Beni, welcome, and his student, Ibu Miss Niken. From UI, Jakarta. So this morning I would like to share our study in Aceh, especially in Lake Laut Tawar. There is two part of the presentation. The firstly is about the Rasbora, the endemic species in Lake Laut Tawar. We can see that this under the picture of the Lake Laut Tawar in Aceh Province. Okay, sorry. Before we start, I would like to overview about the Lake Laut Tawar. Actually, the Lake Laut Tawar is located in Aceh Tengah district. The Aceh province is here. Oh, sorry.
Number two.
Okay. Yeah, okay. The lake is located in the center of Aceh, above 1,200 sea level. And then actually this comes from the caldera, the old caldera. This one, the lake. And then there is many inlet, small river come to the lakes. And then, but only one main lake. Only one main river to discharge from the lake, only one. Presently, the lake is using by the local people for fishing, and then also for agriculture purposes, the water, and also for a small industry around the lake. This some study already done by our colleagues in this Lake Laut Tawar. For example, we have recorded about 11 species of fish, but we believe more than 11. And then the other colleagues also study about plankton, and then bentos, this one. And then also bird. Yeah, there is comprehensive study by our colleagues in this lake. This one is several problem in Lake Laut Tawar actually. The first problem in the lake is declining fish production. You can see that in this picture. For example, in I think the Entekti, the production is about 455 tons per year, and decreased sharply. 2008, only 74 tons per year. That means that the decreasing is higher than 80%. And then the similar problem also occur in Depik. This data is all fish in from the lake, and then this one is only one species, the endemic species. We can see also the same problem. The fish production is decreasing sharply over the 30 years, the last 30 years. Why the fish is declining? There is some cause. One of the important causing is declining of water volume of the lake. This, for example, we can see that this is a watermark at the cliff of the lake. This about 20 years, the water is declining about higher than 2 meters. Decline. You can see this one, watermark. And this condition resulted in drying some of a small river around the lake. This river is the spawning ground of the pig. The pig, when the spawning, they come to this river to spawn. And then the problem is deforestation. We can see that there is the forest already deforested, some problem around the lake, and then also in some season, especially in dry season, this is burning problem. And then the second problem is the presence of alien species in Lake Laut Tawar. The first problem is why the fish production is decreasing. The one problem is by decreasing of the sea water level. And then the second one is presence of alien species. We have studied that there is at least 6 or 7 species of alien fish in Lake Laut Tawar. This one is common carp, Cyprinus, African catfish, Zippoporus, Nile tilapia, tilapia Mozambica. This one is grass carp, yeah, and midfish, and also is like the alien species of fish. This species is compete with the endemic species of the pig, especially on feeding. Because the pig only feed plankton, but this fish, they eat all, not only plankton, everything. So they further problem. And the second, the third one is destructive fishing by the local fishermen. For example, they use very small meshes of the net, very small. But actually, there is regulation in Aceh Tengah district. Yeah, should be have 1.5 centimeter of the meshes. But in the field, the fishermen don't obey this rule. They use very small meshes of the net. Therefore, the net can catch very small fish, including larvae of the pig. And the other problem is also, besides they use small size of gill net, they also use this one is trap, traditional trap. The trap is put in the small river, and then when the brood fish come to the river for spawning, they take fish. Small fish caught by this fishing equipment, and then the brood fish catch by trap. The problem: small they take, and big one they take also. So therefore, the population of the pig decrease. And the other problem is pollution. Yeah, for example, many people culture the fish in the fish cakes, this one. And also agriculture use many fertilizer, many pesticide. And then when in the rainy season, discharge to the lake, everything. Therefore, there is frequently blooming of plankton. Yeah, in the dry season, blooming plankton, but in this lake. Okay, now we talking about fish. Rasbora tawarensis. This is the picture of Rasbora tawarensis. Actually, this small fish, but very important and expensive. Yeah. In Lake Laut Tawar, there is two species of endemic fish. The first one is Depik or Rasbora tawarensis. Tawarensis refer to Lake Laut Tawar. Only occur in Lake Laut Tawar. And the second one is Poropontius tawarensis. This the kind of carp also, but small carp. According to IUCN, this species has been threatened at critical endangered level. It's a very serious problem. Yeah. But this fish is the symbol of Takengon City. If you come to Takengon, for example, if you don't eat this fish, it means that you have not come to this city. Have to try. And then also have to buy the gift, bring to the home. So there's some study already done by our group in Aceh, but many study, but because limited of time, I just show the important thing is. Firstly, is distribution. Yeah, how the fish distribute in the lake. When this picture show that, yeah, this one the relationship between size and depth. The big fish is only found in the depth pool, and then the small fish is distributed in the shallow water close to the coastline. So if the people want to cut more fish, but the size is small, come to the shallow water close to the shoreline, and then the contrary, the bigger fish only found far from the shoreline in the deep pool. That the conclusion of this finding. Is it also same finding? This study is try to see the catching volume between two season, dry and wet season. So based on the finding, we found that more fish in wet season compared to dry season. In dry season, is more fish can harvest. And also we in this picture we can see that between 1 month, the fish is more abundant at the first week and the fourth weeks. This is the duck month. The duck, there is, that mean that the early of month and the end of month depend on the lunar cycle. Now, this one conclusion of the study. The peak is widespread in the lake, but most abundant in shallow water and near to the shore. However, the size is small on average for this area. In contrast, the bigger fish was found in deep water offshore, but with lower abundance. And the second one is the distribution of the fish more spatially than seasonally dependent. However, the production was seasonally and spatially dependent. And then the second study is about the morphometric and genetic variation of the Rasbora. Actually, there is three group of Rasbora in Lake Laut Tawar. Local peoples call that the first is the pig, and then Eas and Relo. But they don't know which one is Rasbora actually. Which one is Rasbora? So the government of Aceh Tengah come to our university to ask me which one is Rasbora, because we would like to make to plan the conservation of the Rasbora, because they know Rasbora is endemic and the symbol of the city, but no information which one. So we try this analysis with two approach, morphometric and genetic. Firstly, we see about the variation of the morphology of the tree of Rasbora. This one is traditional morphometric. We measure the character of the body. And then this one is truss morphometric. This one is the result of finding of the study. We can say that Aceh and Relo overlapping of the character, the similarity of the character between Aceh and Relo is very higher compared to Relo. Relo is spirited in distinguished in different area. The same finding also from the trust network analysis. Yeah, the Depik and Aceh is close, and then the Relo is located in far from the first group. This one is the early indication that Aceh and the Depik may be same species, but Relo is different species. So we have validated this data with genetic data. This one. We take sample of the fin tissue of the Aceh, the Depik, and Relo, and then we use outgroup of the Rasbora. This one is, we already mentioned that Propontius tawarensis, the other one of the endemic species. Now, from this data, we can say that the data of morphology is in agreement with the data of the genetic. It means that the Depik and Aceh is overlap. The sequence haplotype is overlap. They share the haplotype, but the Relo is different. So we show that the Depik and Aceh is same species. The based on information, based on morphology and genetic, and Relo is different species. But still cannot solve the problem, which one is Rasbora. So for this purposes, we use the other one species of Rasbora from outside of the lake. We use, don't know species name, we call that bilis, ikan teri, kalau bahas in Indonesia we call it. From outside of the lake, about more than 200 kilometers from this lake. And then we analyze the genetic. The result show that Rasbora from outside of the lake is very close genetic divergent with Relo. This one, yeah, 0.7. This indication that, yeah, Rasbora from outside of the lake is same species with Relo in Lake Laut Tawar. That mean that Relo is not endemic because they found also in outside of lake. And then the conclusion is Aceh and the Depik is Rasbora tawarensis because only found in this lake. That solve the problem. So now continue study. We focusing with Aceh and Relo. Aceh and Relo is Rasbora tawarensis. We see that how the fish grow in the lake. We use the linear allometric model. The finding so that the peak has the B value is 2.5, indicating that allometric negative growth pattern. Yeah, it means that the the growth of the length is faster than the growth of body weight. The fish look like thin. Because the length is faster than body weight. This one, we try to predict the growth pattern. This one is, this data is a prediction. And then the black one is the direct measurement of the body weight of the fish. You can see that the finding is indicated that the growth pattern is close to the prediction. It means the fish is growing well, as predicted. And then we also compare with the condition factor. We use two of condition factor, Fulton condition factor and relative weight condition factor. Based on this data, we conclude that the condition of the lake is still good and support of the fish to grow because still provide enough food for Rasbora. And then we try to see what kind of feed they feed in the lake. Based on the data, we can see that the Rasbora is plankton feeder. They eat part plankton, zoo and phytoplankton, but the predominant of the plankton is chlorophyce or algae, green algae. This one some picture of the feed. And then we try also to see the overlapping of the diet overlapping between the two species of endemic species, Rasbora tawarensis and Poropontius tawarensis, to see the competition of the fish to for feeding. Poropontius tawarensis and the Depik Rasbora tawarensis. This is the species of the plankton. Some species eat by kawan, some species eat by the pig, and some species also eat kawan and the pig. And then we calculate the data, and based on this calculation, we conclude that there is overlapping feeding between the two of species, but still in moderate degree. Not so high competition between these species. Maybe our suggestion about this is we have to analyze also that overlap between endemic species and introduced species, because like already mentioned that one of the problem is introduced species occur in Lake Laut Tawar. Therefore we have to see maybe to analyze the overlap between tilapia and the pig, but not yet performed. Student will do. Then the other study about the pig is reproductive biology of the pig. There is many data, but this only interesting data I show you. This picture show that we do sample one year sampling. January from December. We can see that every month the male is mature male is higher, the proportion of mature male is higher every month. Then for female, the higher maturation is occur in March, then in September and December. It means that male is ready to spawn every month. But The female is only ready, mostly ready in March, September, and December. Yeah, same like human also maybe. Yeah. And then we try to continue the analysis when the fish is spawned. Based on this data, we make combination, and then the plot like this. This is all the same data. Yeah, we can see that this one, for example, this one female, and the one is male, and then this one is rainfall between the month. We can say that the fish, the pig is spawned during rainy season, in rainy season. This one transition period one in March, in transition period, but dry season no, and then the rainy season also spawn. There is three season of spawning of the pig in March, September, and December, indicating that the fish is multiple spawning. They spawn not only one time every year, but several times. In this data, we find that three times a year. Then we try to analyze what size the fish is mature. Based on data, we can say that this one of male and female. The female, this one female, eh? Female about 84.5 millimeter, mostly already mature. But for male, smaller than the female, indicating that male is mature early than female. Yeah, opposite with human maybe. Yeah, human is I don't know. Maybe a female mature early than male. And also we try analysis about the fecundity. Fecundity is how many eggs produced per spawning season. This data so that if the total length of body weight is increased, the eggs also increase. And the other study is spawning site. We want to try to see where the fish is spawning. So we go to around the lake, yeah, to monitor, and then we recorded there is 13 location of the spawning ground, but only this one is in rainy season. In rainy season, many small river active, but in the dry season, only two spawning is active because the others is dry, no water. This one the picture of the spawning ground. Unfortunately, this let's say. We can see that this one is small river, but this location is belonging by the people. They put trap. This one is trap. They go on trap. When the fish come to this river, cannot come out. They trap and then take the brood fish. Some fish not yet spawn, but some already because there is many. When we see that there is many eggs already released Yeah. No ongoing project breeding and sperm preservation. We have a paper with college, including Martin, to help us to develop, to analyze the data and to read the good paper. They already will be submit to Q1 at least. Q1 at least. Hopefully, yeah. Breeding and sperm preservation. We have tried to spawn this fish, already success. But the problem is the mortality of the larvae is very higher. These are the problem. So we have to stop the problem. But the first problem already solved. We can spawn. And then because of the trip, this population, this fish population, we also develop the preservation of sperm preservation. We take sperm and then we make the methodology, and then we preserve in liquid nitrogen. You already a success also, and will be published soon. This recommendation. This one is program, our program also. We make the community awareness, yeah, especially for the student in surrounding of Lake Laut Tawar. Recommendation: fishing moratorium during spawning season at spawning ground. There's no fishing during spawning season. And then revision of the regulation on the maximum mesh size is 1.7, because now they use 1.0. The actual regulation is 1.5, but using by the people in 1.0. But based on our data, the fish is already mature for male around 7 centimeter, and then for female is about 8 centimeter. Therefore, 1.7 is we think that is good. And then alternative livelihood for the fishermen, because when during moratorium, no fishing, the fishermen still have to eat, still have to need food. Therefore, they have to change the livelihood, maybe for agriculture or something. But the people don't have this skill, so therefore have to train. Now, during spawning, no fishing, go to agriculture land, for example. And then land use regulation around the lake, because around the lake they use for agriculture, they cut many plants, deforested, and so on, and then erosion, maybe siltation also in the lake. And then empowering local capacity and local wisdom. Actually, in Aceh we have local wisdom how to protect the fish and so on. So therefore maybe we can use this wisdom, yeah, in conservation program. And then the important thing is financial support from stakeholder, because very limited support from stakeholder. Only government pay attention. Yeah, we already mentioned that they come to our to discuss how to conserve this species. No, I think still enough time. Because second. Huh? Yeah. Okay. 5 minutes. So now, about eel. Eel. So actually, in our faculty, we focusing on local species. but the local species with a higher price. Higher price. So one of the species is eel. This one, the life history of eel. Actually, eel is very unique because they have three of habitat. For example, they're growing in fresh water, then move to brackish water for a while before they migrate to ocean for spawning. You can see that. Okay. Now, regarding on eel, we have also studied some aspect of eel. This one is to see when the glass eel migrate from the ocean to the river. To see. We make sampling, a 3-month sampling, and then the data so that the glass eel is the larvae of eel, entering the river is at the first week and the third week of lunar calendar, based on the lunar calendar. This week is dark night, at the dark. When we do the sampling in the second or the third weeks, there is no eel. And then we try also study. We have identified that the glass eel come migrate from ocean to the river is the first and the fourth weeks, and then when? This data show us that the glass eel is start to move from the ocean to the river is at 7 p.m. to 1 a.m. After that, no eel, no glass eel. So therefore, this information is very important because right now, there is no technology to spawn the eel, including in Japan. In Japan, they start to spawn Anguilla japonica, Japanese eel. But the technology is still in the lab, not for mass production, for commercial, no. Therefore, the fishermen is very depending on the larvae from the wild. Very depend. In Indonesia, we have culture eel, but the problem is the larvae come from where? Therefore, the emotion is important. And then, this one in Aceh, actually, same like Rasbora, local people say that there is three group of eel. We say that denung, yeah. Ileh dundung, local people. But I don't know which one, what species name. Well, we try to analyze it the morphology. You can see that, yeah. Ileh dundung is overlapping of the character. Maybe the same species. And dundung is different species. So we validated with genetic data. Based on the genetic data, also support the morphological data. It means that Anguilla bicolor, yeah, is this one is, you see, one Anguilla is one Anguilla bicolor, and then this one is Anguilla marmorata and Anguilla bangalensis. But previously, we have only detected on two species, Anguilla marmorata and Anguilla bicolor in Aceh. But after we study DNA, we use glass eel, this one glass eel, larvae. There is one additional species of eel in Aceh, the Anguilla bangalensis. But we cannot find the adult eel, only larvae, this one. the conclusion that there is three species of eel in Aceh: Anguilla bicolor, Anguilla bangalensis, and Anguilla mamorata. All we call that tropical eel. In UK, you have maybe European eel, Anguilla. You have the big one is Anguilla marmorata. This one Anguilla marmorata. This one is Anguilla bicolor, brown color and dark color. It depend on the water where they live. And also we try to see what kind of food they eat. Yeah, mostly they eat crab and shrimp. And then this growth pattern, yeah, we can say that the B value or the slope of data 3.5 indicating that yeah, allometric positive growth pattern, indicating the growth of body weight is faster than line. This same also, yeah, condition factor to see the condition of the environmental. Yes, this conclusion okay, maybe still balance between prey and predator. It means the feed is still the water still provide food for eel. This one parasite examination, because some report from the fishermen, they say that why our fish very slow grow or some fish dead and so on. We try to analyze parasite, yeah, ecto and endoparasite. We find that there is no ectoparasite, but we only found endoparasite. There is two species of parasite, yeah, Procamalanus and Anasakis. This one. This the kind of worm. But this one you can see that Procamalanus only found in intestine. Procamalanus infected intestine, and then Anasakis infected stomach. It's different organ, the infection. This is the picture of the worm. This, and then we try also solve the problem from the fishermen about the feeding level. Feeding level. This feeding level is the best feeding level is because the eel already cultured by the fishermen, but Rasbora not yet. So therefore, we try come to feeding. This one, 10% body weight is better than the other level of feeding. And then this one is natural food for glass eel, because glass eel cannot eat the commercial feed. We have to give natural food. In this study, our student study is very simple study. They used to befriend golden snail, thrush fish, and shrimp. And based on this study, you can see that thrush fish better for growing. Yeah, and then but for to be fed is better for survival. But the problem is the food conversion ratio is still higher. And then stocking density, how many fish per liter to rear it? This study so that if we increase the density, resulted in decreases of body weight. This may be normal. I think that I mean that the theory like this. There's no surprise finding. But also the problem also FCR, food conversion ratio is still higher, 5.2. It means that to get 1 kilogram fish, we have to spend 5 kilogram of feed. So if feed price is in Indonesia, let's say that maybe half pound, 50 pence. But the price of fish is good. 1 kilo is about in rupiah in 150,000. How much? Abidin. Per kilo.
700 pounds.
Good price. This is local price, but if we export to Japan, increase 3-4 times. This one.
Ten pound.
This one, our task to boost the grow of the fish to give the probiotic and enzyme in the feed. The commercial feed, and then we add probiotic and enzyme. The study show that enzyme more important than probiotic. If we put probiotic, we give probiotic, we give enzyme and combination. The study show that enzyme is better. Combination is not good also. Just this one is enzyme papain. Papain enzyme is extracted from papain plant. We extract the enzyme from papain. Okay, finish. Thank you. So, long presentation.